Suppose there are two persons, one is you and another one is a SEO expert. And if you want to hire this SEO expert for your website SEO and don't want to give him a full access of your WordPress website, here's how you do it. So this is my local website. I've created this website sake for this video tutorial. In the dashboard of WordPress, you have to install this plugin. Let's have your mouse over plugins and then click on add new and click on upload plugin. Because we are going to install a premium plugin to make this happen. The plugin that we are going to install comes with the free version as well. Before I install the premium version, let me show you the free version of this plugin. If you come over here and search for all-in-one, and you will see this plugin right here, all-in-one SEO by all-in-one SEO team. But the free version of this plugin can't create separate permissions for your website. So we need to install the pro version of this plugin. You can either go to their website or you can click over here. It will take you to this website right here, aioseo.com. Here you have to buy the premium version of this plugin. If you click over here, let me open link in the new tab. You can see there are several plans for this plugin, basic, plus, pro and light. This is the one of the best SEO plugin out there. And of course, this is not a sponsored video. I've used this plugin for my different types of website. It does more than what you expect from the SEO plugin. So go ahead, take the plan according to your requirement. Once you have the plugin, come back to your website and let's upload the plugin. Since I already have the plugin, I'm going to upload it. And then click on install now. And then click on activate. Next, click on go back dashboard. After you install the plugin, you have to activate the plugin by adding your license key. I've already done it. Next thing you need to do, you need to create a user role. To do it, hover your mouse over user and click on add new. And now you have to type the username for your website. I'm going to type something like SEO. Type the email, first name and last name and skip the website and type the password. And then select the role from here. There is a two types of role here, SEO manager and SEO expert. So if you're wondering what is the difference between the SEO expert and SEO manager? Well, the SEO manager by default have the access to SEO settings for general settings, sitemaps, link assistant, redirects, local SEO, and individual pages and posts. On the other hand, by default, SEO editor have the full access to SEO settings for individual pages and posts. So now I'm going to select the SEO manager and click on add new user. I'm going to click on save. Now you can give your SEO expert that you have hired for your website a new username and password of your WordPress website. In a moment ago, we have created the username and password. Do not give that person the original username and password of your website. We have created a new username and password for that particular SEO expert. And let's see by default what type of access the SEO expert will get when he logs into the backend of your WordPress website. So I'm going to open the private window. Let's try to log in into the backend of your WordPress website. So now you have provided your SEO expert a new username and password. When you type the username and password given by you, and let's see what type of access he will get once he logged in into your WordPress website. All right, guys. So as you can see, this person has only these type of access. He does not have these settings over here. If we open both of these backends side by side and let's see. So now you can see left side is you, and right side is the SEO expert. If I just expand this one, in your website, you have the full access, like your settings and other features. And this person does not have these kind of access of your WordPress website. At this point, you can remove or add any access of your website for that particular SEO expert. Let's go to all-in-one SEO and then click on general settings. And here, go to access control. And here you can see we have the SEO manager, SEO editor. Now it's set to use by default settings. Let's uncheck this option. Here you can see you can still remove any type of access for that particular SEO expert, or you can add any access that you like. Once you make any changes, don't forget to click on save settings. So that's it. This is how you give a permission to another person to access your WordPress website. If you found this video useful, don't forget to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more videos. Till then, I'll see you next time.